Hello and welcome back to another redstone tutorial. Today I would like to show you the Chupacabra farm I've built for Lycanites mobs in the RLcraft mod pack. The cooked Chupacabra meat heals you for 3.5 hearts. Since other types of food in RLcraft do not heal, this farm is great for early game before you get the more powerful items. I start by placing 2 rows of hoppers facing forward, which can be as long as needed. Add a double chest at the end. Rails and a minecart with hopper would work here as well. Then place 2 rows of stone slabs on top of the hoppers. Add 2 layers of solid blocks around the sides of the slabs. You will want to use stairs or glass blocks above the chest. I place open trapdoors along the top block on one side. Then add buckets of lava on the other side above the slabs. The baby chupacabras can stand under the lava safely, but when they grow up, they will catch on fire and drop the cooked meat. Then add a row of slabs above the lava. Build up a layer of solid blocks surrounding the trap doors. Cover the top as well, so there is a small gap beside the slabs. Then I add a bucket of water on the side surrounded with blocks, so it flows into the chamber. Now you can lure some chupacabras into the water. They spawn frequently inside caves in all biomes. This does work if they are tamed, but unless you change the config, the wild chupacabras will not despawn. You could also use a rock to carry them over and drop them in the farm. Some are too small and will fall through the trap doors. Some chupacabras are too big to fit in the farm at all, but most of the time it will work. Add 2 layers of blocks around the slabs. Then place more open trap doors beside the top row. Add 2 more layers of blocks to hold the animals. You can put cows, sheep, or pigs up here. I suggest covering this as well so other hostile mobs can't attack them. Now, when you breed the farm animals, the offspring will fall through the trap doors and the chupacabras will eat them. This causes them to breed and the young drop down to the lowest chamber. Once they've grown, the lava will kill them, dropping leather and cooked chupacabra meat. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and I would love to hear what you think of it. My survival RLcraft playthrough is going well, and I wanted to give you a quick update. I cleared my first Lycanite dungeon, using glowstone blocks to light the floor as I go. The sylph farm has already produced way more than I need. I was able to kill almost everything using my summoning rod to spawn aggressive Aegis. Whenever I take damage, I can summon a Jangu, which combines with the Aegis to make a healing nymph. When I got to the final chamber, I noticed that the Ignis dragon boss had his head stuck in the ceiling. This was very fortunate, as he would have surely killed me otherwise. I ran back to the iron farm to trade for some emeralds and make the dragon treats. Then I used a soulstone and equipped him with a saddle so I can fly around and rain fire on my foes. His dragon breath can be used constantly, but I had to be careful not to set everything on fire. We finally got enough wither skulls to make a portal to the lost cities. It also requires 2 blocks of emeralds. So I grabbed some iron gear and my summoning staff and set out for adventure. I entered the first building I came across and got the message that I feel uneasy. Monsters started spawning around me, and I killed the first few. Then I got one shot and lost all my stuff because I was sent to a new random location. I died a couple times, but eventually found a village and activated the waystone to set my spawn. I found some iron and torches in the village before accidentally catching it on fire. So I moved into one of the many non-flammable concrete buildings to start gathering supplies. Using my dragon, I could safely kill everything outside, but he does not work well in small spaces. I was lucky and got an ender pearl from the trick-or-treat bags, which can drop during the week of Halloween. I also got some gold ingots by smelting the armor that I found. I crafted another summoning rod, and it was smooth sailing from there. I was able to kill the three bosses in my basement by just standing on the ladder above them and spawning the Aegis on aggressive. I had planned to just build another portal to escape, but I found out you can't use them in the Lost Cities. Also, the wormhole potions don't work in this dimension. So I will be stuck here until I can find 6 Wither Skulls to make the portal back. Luckily, Wither Skeletons do spawn here, and the Reapers can drop the skulls as well. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.